Hey there, Honors Algebra 2. I hope you're all having a great day. Today is Monday, May 4th, and may the 4th be with you. We are in the penultimate week of our e-learning, as this week is a week of instruction, next week is a wave week, and the final week of instruction will be May 18th through the 22nd. And so we are just 3 short weeks away from being done for this school year. So let's talk about first what we're going to do this week and also the final week, and then we'll get into what will happen with some district announcements. So let's talk about this week. So this week we are starting a new unit today. We'll do 6.1 through 6.4 Monday through Thursday this week. We'll take a unit section each day. And then on Friday you'll have a quiz on 6.1 through 6.4. When we get back on the 18th through the 22nd, we will do 6.6, 6.7, and 6.8 together. It's a short section that we'll do and combine some things together. And then 6.9 will be Wednesday, which will be the 20th. And so then that will leave a quiz on those 4 sections on Thursday. And then you will have the unit test, the final unit test on Unit 6 on Friday, May 22nd. So let me talk about how that's going to work as we close out the year. And so understand this, that May 22nd is the date that all zeros will be put in for missing assignments. My grades are due by that following Wednesday, which means if you have anything missing and I put in a zero for it, the last day I will accept it is by noon on Tuesday, May 26th. That is the drop-dead deadline for me to finish off your grades and get them submitted with the time that I need to do to get those last things graded. So again, this week is an e-learning week. Next week is a wave week. The week of the 18th is an e-learning week. You will have a test on May 22nd. Everything that I need is due no later than May 22nd, other than the final few things in that last week. If you are missing things coming into that last week from March and April, those need to get done now. Seriously. Some of you have multiple missing assignments, and you need to get them done now. Most of you have done well with this. Again, there's a couple who have like maybe 1 or 2 assignments missing. There's some who have turned in every single thing, and I thank you for that, and we're going to get through these last couple weeks well. But the few of you in this class who have not done diddly squat need to get your rear in gear before you end up failing this class. And that is me putting it as sternly as I can over this video. And so understand that you have 3 weeks left. If you are in the position that you have done nothing, you have 3 weeks left. Get it done. Otherwise, you are in danger of failing this class because everything will go in as a zero and you will not have a passing grade because all of these grades are on fourth quarter. So get it done. So with that being said, with 6.1 today, it is a fairly decent lesson on exponential functions, exponential growth, and exponential decay. That video will probably take about 20 to 25 minutes to talk about both pieces. And then your assignment will be 13 questions. The first 6 are just graphing. And then the final 9 are word problem type problems, application problems on exponential growth and decay. Because with exponential growth and decay, that is really where we need to buckle down on that. So with that being said, district stuff, obviously you should have gotten the newsletter from the school on Friday. You should have gotten a call from Marianne Bird yesterday detailing out again that this is an e-learning week. For those who have siblings dealing with graduation, remember graduation is still on for May 29th at 9:45 a.m. And each family will get 2 tickets. Each graduate will get 2 tickets for graduation. So keep those things in mind as we close out these next couple weeks. Office hours are 11 to 2. I have the Google Meet in Google Classroom. So if you go to Google Classroom and you click at the top of our class page where you can see the stream, there's a link to a Google Meet in your Google Classroom for my class. And all you need to do is send me an email and say, hey, Mr. McMillan, can you jump in the Google Meet? I'll say, absolutely. And we'll jump together and work on what you need to work on. I am here to help you. But if you don't reach out, you are working on your own island. And some of you have been working on your own island for weeks. if y'all want to get a time together that multiples of you want to do at one time, if all of you want to say like 11:30, 12 o'clock, whatever the case might be, that is fine with me. If you want to, I know y'all have your group chat together, but that is up to y'all. If you want to individually get in there and talk about the assignments, that's fine as well. But y'all need to get your stuff done, and I hope y'all are doing well. Reach out if you need us. Your guidance counselors are available if you need to talk to them about anything going on. I hope y'all are staying safe, stay healthy, stay home, socially distance. And it looks like we're getting on the back end of this with everything starting to open up. Hey, restaurants get to eat outside now. So go partake in that. But again, be smart about the decisions you make. And I hope, again, if you need anything, that you would reach out and contact either myself, one of your other teachers, or your guidance counselor for whatever you may need. Again, we're here for you as we close out these last few weeks of the school year. So on that note, I'm going to say bye. The word of the day is May the 4th be with you, because today is Star Wars Day. So again, May the 4th be with you.